Welcome to this guided tour of the eClasses virtual classroom. We'll look at features of the classroom and you'll get to see some of them in a live online session. This is the eClasses classroom. The largest area on the screen is the media window, where content will be displayed. This could be a whiteboard space, a PowerPoint slide, an image, document, or even a web page. If the instructor has preloaded content, it will be indicated in the agenda bar here. At times, you will be able to interact with the content by using the markup tools found to the left of the media window. For example, you can add text, symbols, or use the draw tool. In this screenshot, you can see some of these features in use. The instructor has asked a question and participants have added their responses onto the whiteboard. Participants in the session are listed in the attendees window, with the instructor or presenter's names appearing with a gray background. This is one of the ways that we see each other in the classroom. To speak in a session, you click the Talk button. The microphone symbol beside your name will be green while you have it on. One of the exciting features of eClasses is the interaction toolbar found at the top left of the screen. Clicking on these tools gives you the opportunity to participate actively throughout the session, even when you are not speaking. You can raise your hand if you have a question, respond yes or no, show when you've stepped out of the classroom, and you can even indicate laughter or applause to add some personality to your interactions. When you use one of these tools, a small symbol will appear beside your name in the attendees window so everyone can see your input. The text chat window provides even more opportunity for interaction and communication. These are great examples of how to interact in the eClasses classroom. Now, let's have a brief look at a live session. We will watch and listen from the viewpoint of Carole Drew, a sample student, as she participates in this business class.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's session, Business Fundamentals. We're going to pick up the conversation where we left off last week, so let's get started. In last week's class, we looked at some of the details that you need to cover when you write your business plan. Unlike the cartoon that we see in the media window, planning a business actually has a lot of detail and can take a lot of time. We wish a business model was this simple. Let's go to our whiteboard and review some of the details from last week. Go ahead and use your markup tools, please. Add your ideas. What are some components of a business plan? Very nice. Thanks, everyone. Those look like some great ideas. When you think about the steps to planning a business, we covered the first few last week. This week, let's focus on registering a business name, getting a tax identification number, and registering for different tax programs. Carole, I see your hand raised. Go ahead, please, with your question or comment.
I'm just wondering how I know what permits I need to get for my business.
Good question, thank you. Service Ontario has a great website. I'm going to do an app share now so that we can see it. In your media window now, you should see the One Source for Business website. They have a number of tools and wizards. You can also search under topics. There's a topic called Getting Permits and Licenses. So you'll find a lot of information here. So thinking about the work that you've done so far, where would you say you are in your business planning stage? Go ahead, everyone, please. Vote if you would like. We'll see the results of where people are in their business planning. Here are the results if you're curious. Great job, everyone.
In this brief tour, we've introduced some of the interactive features of eClasses. You can find out more by visiting www.contactnorth.ca.